Now, I'm being a little cryptic here. What do I mean by ratios? Let's go back to our similar triangles to figure out what I mean. Now, I have two triangles here. They're similar because the angles match, but the sides are different. I'm going to label these sides little a, little b, and little c, and these sides big A, big B, and big C. And you can see that even though these sides are all longer, there's some correspondence between side big A and side little a. Likewise with the big C and the little c and the big B and the little b. But what exactly is that correspondence? What do these things all have in common? And the fact is, they have a ratio in common. And what I mean by that is they're linked through ratios. So if I look at the ratio of side big A to side big B, I'm going to find that's exactly the same as the ratio of side little a to side little c. In fact, it doesn't matter how big or small I make this triangle, this equality will always hold true, and that's a really powerful mathematical tool that we can use. So, for example, let's say I didn't give you variable names here, but I give you some actual numbers. So, 3 meters, 4 meters, and 5 meters are replacing our size from before, and these are still unknown. But let's say I told you that, I don't know, side big B was equal to 6 meters. I can use this to calculate side big C, because I know that C over big B has to equal, well, the corresponding sides, 4 over 3. More precisely, 4 meters over 3 meters. And notice that when we do this, the units cancel out, so it doesn't even matter that we were using meters. We could have been using inches or stadia or furlongs or any unit we'd like. Okay, so now I know this ratio, C over B is equal to 4 over 3. But notice that I have one other piece of information. Big B is actually equal to 6 meters. So let's write that in. Now if I want to solve for C, I multiply both sides by 6 meters, and that gives me the following. C equals 4 over 3 times 6 meters, also known as 8 meters. Okay, that wasn't so bad. We used the power of ratios to calculate an unknown side of a triangle, and this is a huge tool to have at our disposal. Can you do the same to solve for side A? How long is side A in meters? And you can just enter the number. You don't have to type in the M.